name is Andy Myers. In today's episode, guest ASM artist and painter Josh Ackerman will be showing you his full process of painting a Fang Fighter. There are no judges, no prizes, and the paint casual ships will not be given away. Calmly settle in and enjoy watching paint dry.
So this initial layer doesn't need to be perfect, you just want to cover the whole ship. these ones with the movable wings. So I gotta be careful not to get the paint inside of that area there so it can still pivot and not be an issue. I don't know how much of an issue it will be, but I've painted fangs, but not these movable wing ones. First time painter, and you're wondering why I added water to this paint. It doesn't need it, but it helps it go on smoother, and it doesn't go on as thick, and you can really spread it around, and that's what you want to do on these base coats. Up now. So I think I got all the edges I want to get on this first base coat. And it's got to dry. So we're going to put it back on its base. Set it off to the side. This dry, and we'll have to come back to it when this dries. So we'll catch you in a little bit. So it looks like we'll need a second coat on here of this base. painted the part that connects and rotates. Because I want those other parts to get dry first. I'm also trying not to paint the cockpit. And leave that as much as original as I can. I find it's a lot easier to come back through and touch it up or scrape it off with a straight edge. On ships, just because you're not seeing them, unless you are flying them around, going pew 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 with them. But being these wings move, I figure we gotta spend a little bit more time on the bottom as well. I also don't know yet how I'm gonna, what paint scheme I'm gonna do on this. If any. For a base coat, this is looking like it's done again. The second one went in nice and good. It doesn't need to be perfect because it's going to be covered up by the oncoming paints. You just want to make sure that the original colors are kind of buried. So again, we'll let that sit and dry. base coat is complete. Well, this is what happens with these movable ones. I have a nice base coat, but now it's kind of stuck. That was what I was worried about with these. Just need to get loosened a little bit. Okay. So, as you can see, let's put this right in the middle there. I'll try to see. Our base coat. Now we're going to add the lighter green to the wings, I think. Get into our stuff here. So I'm going to use a flat brush. Moot green. That can be seen. That's what we're going to be using. Sorry, I'm going to take just a little water. Put it in our tray. Green.
Okay, we're getting that green on there. So I'm going to use the darker green, I think, as in the center, and then on the wings is the idea. Maybe there'll be some of this lighter green off the front. So trying to find the complements for the greens. So this is going on a little bit light, which is fine because we can come back and add more. So one thing you could do, since you're going to be putting on colors on top of each other, is I could paint the whole thing in this light green and then go over with the darker colors or even the lighter colors with these paints. Like the yellow is just, yellow to paint is not fun. It just takes so many coats, which so I'm going to be using yellow a little bit, but not a lot. So right now I'm just putting on the second coat of green, and I'll maybe try to zoom in on this here in a second. Close. normally don't care about the bottoms too much because you're not seeing them, but we with this one able to rotate, if they decide to rotate it, it will be seen. So I'm trying to get a little bit more paint for that. That's what it's currently looking like. Get a little bit more of this moot green. A little water. Bend it down a little bit. So, probably one more coat on the top here, because there's a couple spots. So maybe we'll just hit those spots. A little bit of water. Thin this down some more.
I come upstairs.
That was our Alexa that's supposed to not let that stuff through. So I have a little spot here. I don't know if it can be seen. I gotta keep an eye on, see if it's gonna darken up on me. Put a little bit more paint there. So I'm curious on what colors I'm going to do, because there's some nice panels here that I can do stuff with, but first I'm going to put the darker green down the center, on the center cockpit area. So I'm going to set that off to the side. I get to hear some of this. Clean water. Put that on the board. We have some Elysian green. Right now, we're just going to go straight colors. Because I found that mixing colors while getting stuff close if you don't mix it enough makes it real hard to copy that color. Since it's the first time using this color on this thing, I'm going to put some on the bottom. See if I like it. I think it'll be a nice So this is thinned down pretty good. Almost tempted to add a little bit more paint so it goes on a little thicker, so we don't have to do it twice, but it's not a lot of area. coming up. Tried to thicken up the paint a little bit. I'm using just a little bit too watery. Now it seems like it's too painty, but that's starting to come together pretty good. We obviously have some more layers to do with the cockpit, but if I can do that now and let it dry, think we're gonna let this dry a little bit. Check back on it in a couple minutes. It's been a couple minutes. It looks like we can put another layer of this green on. It hasn't quite dried up on the board yet, so for now, that green is done. So the question is, am I going to start mixing some colors into the other sections? So I have yellow, white, the metallic for the boosters, and guns, and touching up the cockpit. So it's got some nice lines that we could copy. I feel that's done a lot, but take a closer look here. Underneath with the lighter green. Let's try to a little bit left. Let's try to cover that and touch that up. See if that takes. Better. I don't know. I think we can do the boosters. Those are not going to change. So I have some old Citadel bolt gun metal, wherever it is here, that I've used for many years because I don't use a lot of it. Much in there, but if I take a little bit of water, put it in there, bring up a little paint, it's a little runny, a little bit more paint. Serious when I take off. I wear glasses, and if I take off my glasses, so I can really get in there. I can try to do this here. There are some touch-ups I have to do inside there. I'll have to try to get. You can see that's starting to fill in nicely. It gives a nice metallic. I'm just gonna put this silver all the way around. I'm gonna maybe do something different on the ends, but I think that whole thing covered. I think I'm gonna have to get the part that twists there in this color too. So I have to grab a different brush for that. So I know that's not really zoomed in on there, but I really gotta get in here. It's hard to see because I don't want to touch where I haven't painted. But I'm just trying to get into the where it connects in there. as you can see, hopefully here. I've been getting in there. So that's probably going to be the best we're going to get on that. I like how that turned out. So I think we can safely hit these guns. Just give them a little... This tip is not my favorite. So I got some really... There's a decent set of... Amazon, these virtuoso little brushes, but they are cheaper and they run out quicker. We hit those, so that's popping up already. So we've got a little bit more finer edge. I can maybe get a little bit closer. Just on these top edges. This silver, you don't have to go over it too many times to get it right. I think that's in currently where I want everything for the major. I might come by through and hit some of the raised panels, but for now silver is good. So that allowed everything else to dry. So now we come back to accent colors we have to decide. That cockpit area I think is going to get so these lines here. Let me use this to point with. So these lines on both sides there, that would be a good color to go across. Same with that one. Or this one might get that lighter green. If I go with lighter green there and down the nose. And maybe the lighter green on each side of the thruster is there. And these edges, I think I'm going to go... I'm gonna go white on the edges. Maybe white across there and then yellow, yellow, white tip and maybe yellow on those lines there. We'll have to see, but first we'll start with that green because I have some other touch up of this lighter, this light green to do. So we'll do another round of light green. Okay, so let's find our touch-up spots first. So we are going to try to do those lines. The line for that doesn't go down around underneath, so we will just do it on the top and end it on the side. Try down that center. All I'm doing is following currently just the lines of the ship. I'm standing probably not really in frame right now, but trying to just get what I want painted and not have to do a lot of other stuff. That's what we're looking like right now. Since I'm using water down where I've painted, I have to hit twice. Nice thing is with it, dries fairly quick. When you put it on lighter, so I'm liking how that's coming together. So I'm really trying to figure out some accent lines here. Trying to figure out if I need some of this lighter green on the tail. So I could follow this green line all the way through, put just a single actual green line down that, and then out the back. What do we think? I gotta leave it for right now and let that dry. I'm gonna put one more coat on this stuff, these highlights. So let's entertain our yellow. Maybe it'd be a yellow strip off the back. Where's the yellow? This is Flash Glitz Yellow. It's really yellow, but it takes a little bit to get on there, so I don't want to use a lot of it. I'm thinking I can use it for the boosters. But what I like to do is I like to put some white in there first, a dab of white, and then a little bit of yellow, and it can kind of mix fiery on there. We just gotta figure out where this yellow is gonna go. Maybe one thought that might be kind of fun is I just try to get yellow right on that edge. So it's only seen when you rotate it. From the top at least. That might be interesting. It's gonna be real tight to do that. those ends are going to be white. It looks like I'm at the gray that they're at right now. Honestly. I may leave those gray. They're growing on me. I think I'm going to do a strip of white right on that edge. There and there. And then here in the front. So I need a little bit of water again. Not a lot. This stuff is kind of runny. Then I'm going to need a liner. So pro tip, to get, where is it, a nice tip, put a little saliva on it, gets you a nice clean tip. So much for doing lines of paint on here, it'll go nice and easy. So here we go. Take another peg off. I'd like to set this down. That went on pretty good. Turning out good. So I'm gonna take a little bit more. I'm gonna just try to do this front a little bit. And then we're gonna try to do the back line. So as you can see, I'm getting those in there. You'll get the bottom here in a minute, but I just want to make sure this top is nice and set up nicely up here. So I do like that. That worked out well. Now, for sure want to do up here too. So not the very front, but the whole line set you could do. You can do that over, and I don't know if that'll be too much. I'm just going to do this one down here. And all you're doing is following the lines that are there. Get underneath again later. So I'm gonna have to hit it again, but I think that's honestly all the yellow we're gonna need. I don't know. The yellow lines down this last bit here. Honestly, I don't know. Do I do yellow across there? That would wrap around on the center, but... starting to come together. So the other two colors we have are white and black. White's gonna go on the tips here. I don't know, that maybe that gray is staying. That gray gives a nice Let's get the white where we know we're putting the white. in yellow, so maybe my instant rinse. I'm gonna take a think about this for a minute. All right, so let's get that white on here. Just using white scar. That white on this front. Some of that white on there. So I think we can get white on that line there. And give us some white there and white there. So we're gonna try that. think that's what's working. Come on. There we go. I'm not even in the frame. Come on. Yeah, that's working. Well, that dries. We can do a little bit of clean up. This isn't scraping off like it normally does. So I'm gonna have to hit that up. Clean those edges up. First, let's get a little dollop of white in the engines. Bloop. I'm just gonna take just a little bit of yellow. little bit of yellow afterburner here. I think there's something in this one. That was about just had just a little bit of this yellow in there. We have our flames. So I think I have to touch up the cockpit. I think it's just the cockpit. So we are going to need the black. So hopefully we don't screw this up. So we got the cockpit done, I think. Some of our shading should help with that. And I'm thinking a little bit more of that light green maybe behind the cockpit. just to break that up just a little bit more. So we're going to do that. Because any of the other colors are going to be too much. I think the green is the way to break that. Maybe we copy that stripe pattern. For this, I'm just going to go straight from the paint thing. Some water. So it's going on a little gloppy for me. That's starting to come together real good. Just that little bit of color helps it progress it back, I think. Yeah, I think I'm going to do a little bit of white too back there. Just to copy that line. So these ones aren't really following the lines of the ship necessarily. I'm liking that. I'm digging that right there. It's just enough to give it some color. So let that dry. I might have to hit it with another white spot there, but I'm gonna hit these front ones. At least the tops. Maybe the front edge again. Everyone has their own style of how they like to have their colors. Some are going to put a little bit darker version of the green and shade it, and those look really awesome, but that's just not my style. so I'm gonna... I like it how it is right now, so I'm gonna send it off to Mr. Andy. See if he digs that. And if he does, we will put the wash on it, because I think it's, I like it where it's at. I could keep adding stuff, and at some point it would be too much. Alright, there was one other thing I was going to do to this, and that was, let's see if this is still, nope, that's not ready yet, is a little bit more of this silver. Adding some silver to these, some of these raised spots. It's looking pretty good. It's breaking up that green. Hit it back up on the bottom just to get something different. Get this long, one on the side is worth getting. Yeah, that looks nice. think. Done. Yep, I think I just got, and oh, that gun's fine. Thought about doing the cockpit lines, but those. Try it. A little bit of this green. A little bit of water. To get this in frame, so if I screw it up, everybody can see me screw it up. There, we got the cockpit lined. A little bit deeper than I wanted, but I think it's okay. It's hitting lines. So there we go. Now we will give it its wash. So you just have some noon oil. Take our bigger brush, get some water. Thin it down. Just a little bit more water. So you can see I've got just a that, and then we're gonna we'll start from the front and pull it back. It's gonna fill in all your little lines. holding it vertical to have the oil come down to the back, because that would be the direction of flight. So it's the direction I want the shadows to be in. So, trying to limit some of the pooling. Some of the spots. But I want those lines to stay filled in, because that's looking real good wet. And with that, we let this dry. Take a little bit. Let's see how that dries. So here it is, all dried. Let's try to get my hand out of there. There we go. That is Fang Fighter. Now we just clean up.
Available for commissions. Check out his link in the video description. if you are a casual painter interested in being paid to be in an episode of Paint Casual, please contact Andy at glitterstimasmr@gmail.com. If you like this ASMR content or appreciate the absurdist creative humor, please like this video and subscribe to the YouTube channel. Then head to www.patreon.com/glitterstimasmr and sign up to be on the Jedi Council to offer your ideas for future episodes of this ridiculous project. Thanks, and may the Force be with you. Pew, pew, pew.